It takes a bit of intelligence to pass a driving test. You need to learn how to control the car, you need to learn the rules of the road, and you even need to learn to get into the mindset of other drivers. So how would you feel if you pulled up at the traffic lights and the car next to you was driving itself? Well, for people in California and Nevada, that's no longer science fiction. As of May 2012, the world's first robotic car has its driving license. The driverless car is the result of nearly a decade of research by scientists and engineers at Stanford University and Google. In 2004, the United States military ran a competition with a $1 million prize for the first driverless car to make it 150 miles through the desert. The Department of Defense got to keep its money. The car that did the best only managed 7.5 miles before getting stuck on a rock. But in 2005, Professor Sebastian Throne from Stanford University in his car Stanley managed to complete the entire 150-mile course in just under 7 hours. Since then, Professor Throne's been concentrating on a far more challenging aspect of town driving, which involved things like looking out for pedestrians, dealing with other traffic, and even reading road signs. But what are the ethics of driverless cars? If a driverless car is in a collision, who's responsible? And if it turns out that robots are better drivers than we are, could we see a day when human beings are no longer allowed to take the wheel? Driverless cars are definitely on the horizon, and we're going to have to learn how to share the road. But until then, we'll just have to keep driving.